Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 15, where we are talking about the bones of the leg. So the tibia and the fibula, not the tibula and the fibia. Sometimes I hear it said that way, but let's make sure that we get that pronunciation correct. Now, looking at the same image that we kind of been returning to in terms of the lower limb, you can really clearly see the tibia here. The tibia is going to be the largest of the bones of the legs. It will be the weight-bearing bone. It will also be the medial bone. And I can't really see the fibula, can you? There's not much of it there. I can see a little bit right here of the lateral malleolus of the fibula. But in terms of the shaft, I'm not seeing it all that well. I think I might see a little bit of it right there. I think that we've kind of rotated this a little to the medial side, so the fibula is not quite as visible here, but it would be kind of following along this region right here. So the fibula will be lateral, whereas the tibia will be medial. So looking at the individual tibia, the proximal portion is going to be part of the articulation of the knee joint, and this distal portion will articulate with the talus and the fibula, and you will have that formation of the talocrural joint. In this proximal portion, you're going to have these really flat areas, which are the condyles. And I would really only ask you to identify the condyles in a full with a full tibia, just because I think it's so easy to tell that this is the medial malleolus, and that medial malleolus is always medial, right? Just like its name would say. So this would be the medial condyle, whereas this would be the lateral condyle. Now, I would not ask you to identify the two condyles in this specific image, but I did put it here just because I really wanted you to be able to see how shallow these condyles are. So you had those fairly large femoral condyles that are fitting in these very shallow medial and lateral tibial condyles. So that's why you don't have that really great fit between the knee, so it's relatively unstable. This would actually be the lateral and the medial, but again, I won't have you identify it from this particular view. Now, back to this image over here. This is a straight anterior view, and I know that because I can really see this tibial tuberosity that's right in this region. And this is going to be that distal attachment site for the quadriceps tendon, or that specific portion from the patella down to the tibial tuberosity is referred to as the patellar ligament. So that is always going to be anterior. You can actually palpate your own tibial tuberosity. You'll clearly be able to palpate your patella. And then if you move down inferior or distal to that, you should feel that tibial tuberosity that's projecting anteriorly. And then again, in this distal portion here, this medial projection is going to be the medial malleolus, and you will have a matching lateral malleolus on the fibula. So looking at that fibula that we couldn't see very well on that first image, you see that it is a very long but very thin bone, and it will have a kind of more robust proximal end and distal end. And the proximal end is going to be the head, and the distal end will be the lateral malleolus. And so it is difficult, I think, to tell which way is up and which way is down. So when you're looking at the head, it's a bit more triangular in shape, a bit more bulbous. So this is going to be the head, whereas the lateral malleolus is kind of more tapered in terms of appearance. So not kind of trying to be more angular, it's more tapered. This is going to be a little bit longer too in terms of its projection. So that will be the lateral malleolus. So just keep in mind that these two structures and being able to tell them apart is a pretty difficult thing. Many osteologists, you'll see them kind of holding a fibula and flipping it up and down, trying to figure out which side is which. But that articular surface for the lateral malleolus will be facing towards the medial side, which we can't really see here. This is a more posterior lateral view. But that would be facing towards talus, because it's going to be part of that talocrural joint or ankle joint. Okay, so that is the tibia and the fibula and the things that we want you to be able to identify here. We will continue our discussion of the bones of the lower limb with the bones of the tarsal bones as well as the feet. So I will see you at the next station. Please reach out with any questions.